Fishin Affliction. Hello.
It's time to wet a line. It's Fishin Affliction time for those who got it bad.
Well, Mom and Dad's grab the kids, it's time for the fishing show. Me and the big dog's gonna go catch them down at the fishing hole. Well, you better stick around, cause you don't know what you're missing. Yeah, me and the big dog's got that fishing affliction. Grab your hats, grab your baits, don't forget your poles. We're gonna fire up that old Ranger boat and head to the fishing hole. We're gonna try to catch a big one. Yeah, that's what we're wishing. Cause me and the big dog's got that fishing affliction. Yeah, me and the big dog's got that fishing affliction. Yeah. Yeah, and we've got it bad.
I've got that fishing affliction.
Hey, I'm Art Defoe, and I've got that fishing affliction.
Hi, I'm Denny Brower, and I've got that fishing affliction.
Hey, I'm Mark Menendez, and I've got that fishing affliction.
I'm Bobby Lane, and I got that fishing affliction.
Hi, I'm Chris Lane, and I got that fishing affliction.
I'm Shaw Grigsby, and I got that fishing affliction.
Just like me. Here, fishy, fishy here, fishy, fishy here, fishy, fishy here.
So blessed to be on this lake, because this lake is full of fish like this.
Man, that's awesome, Sam. Awesome.
Folks, it's time to wet a line because it's Fishin' Affliction time, and welcome into today's episode as we continue with part two of the Bassassination on Kentucky Lake, featuring the big dog, myself, and Affliction pro staffer and tournament powerhouse Slammin' Sam Lashlee, catching largemouths like most of us only dream about. Our Fishin' Affliction product spotlight will feature the sharpest hooks on the planet, Mustad. And folks, head on over to our online store because those Fishin' Affliction tournament jerseys are on sale at a great price. And if you can't get enough Fishin' Affliction TV, then subscribe to us there at our YouTube channel. And at the end of the show, you'll meet the Fishin' Affliction Facebook Friend of the Week. So sit back and enjoy part two, the Bassassination of Kentucky Lake, featuring the big dog, myself, and Affliction pro staffer and tournament powerhouse Slammin Sam Lashlee, right here on Fishin Affliction TV.
Well, this was tugging, tugging, tugging.
Well, folks, we're going to start this episode where we left off with the last episode, with the guys assassinating those big old Kentucky Lake largemouths.
But some of them good ones weigh almost 5 pounds, like that one.
Need a good solid.
That high four, Sam, near five?
Well, I'd say he's three.
Is that three?
Yeah.
Man. There's just something about Kentucky Lake. The fish just look bigger.
Well. And you don't know how Sam evaluates fish.
All right.
If I catch a 3 3/4, he's three. If he gets a 3 3/4, he's 4 1/4. So you just have to know how he evaluates.
Unless we're in a tournament together.
You know, the more that I do look at that fish, big dog, I do think he's probably more like two.
Yeah.
Well, I hope I get some twos the rest of the year.
You boxing that?
No, not this one. Mm. That's a good solid 3 pounder. Three and a quarter, 3.5 pound fish.
He was skinny.
All right, go catch one with those smarts can out there.
Here we go. And 1, 2, 3, jump. Okay. 1.5. 1.5 fish.
Are we best assassinating them again?
Again, assassinating.
Woo!
The Bassassination 2012 has officially begun.
Another 3 pounder.
Wow. Well, and another set of doubles.
Imagine that.
Man, that's awesome. Big dog, what are you in a hurry for?
bat.
Because when you're fishing with a fishing machine, you got to be a fishing machine.
I hear you.
Well, you got me down 3 5-pounders to 2 5-pounders.
No, 4.
That ain't no
one. Another double. Oh, look at that dude.
This one loads out.
Man, that's an acrobatic.
Another leech on him.
Killed some leeches today, that's good.
Wonder if they let you weigh in the leeches.
They're getting smaller, maybe I ought to go to the big fish hole.
We've already had what? 4 5-pounders right here?
Mm.
It's 25 pounds in the tournament. That'd be pretty nice, wouldn't it?
Man. Sexy dog fish, huh, Sam?
Yes, sir.
That's a good solid 2 1/4-pound fish.
We've already got 5 5-pounders, so we got that 60 pound.
I got one on right here. This one feels a little pretty solid. Look, Dan, this one's getting ready to jump.
Oh, we goodness. It. Look,
here we go. Double it again.
Oh, my gosh.
Another one. Another one. Another set of doubles. He's got one up.
I think yours is a little better than mine.
Now you see why I like Kentucky Lake so much.
Well, folks, the guys are catching them 2 at a time as the Bassassination on Kentucky Lake continues. And in a moment, we'll be right back with some more fish in action. But right now, let's go see some pictures from this week's
In the Wild.
Folks, whether day or night, Cody Madison has been catching some big old largemouths. Look at this daytime giant, followed by this Percy Priest nighttime monster. And here's another big old fish caught from Percy Priest by Mr. Stuart Miller, who landed this beautiful hybrid striped bass. And Triton McLean was fishing a mystery lake when he landed this absolute monster largemouth. Great fish, Triton, and thanks to everybody for sending those pictures. Folks, you can send us your pictures to pics@fishandaffliction.com or leave them there at our Facebook page, and maybe you'll see your pictures right here on the big screen.
In the Wild. Your pictures in the wild.
You know, some of the first spinnerbaits that I ever threw growing up in Michigan had painted blades on them. The new Strike King Tour Grade painted blade spinnerbaits, they have that supernatural look. I mean, when you look at the sexy shad color going through the water, it looks like a school of sexy shad.
It's not just a white blade. It's not just a chartreuse blade. It's a, you know, it's got the natural bait fish look.
When we say Tour Grade, when you pull it out of the package, it's ready to go. It's got every possible component at its very top-notch best.
Smyrna Ready Mix is an established company that handles business daily with integrity and professionalism. Whether you're a general contractor, professional builder, or a do-it-yourself homeowner, SRM has your concrete solutions. With several convenient locations in the Middle Tennessee area to serve you, the only call you need to make is to SRM, ready to serve you with integrity and professionalism.
Tennessee boat operators born after January 1, 1989 must show a Tennessee Wildlife Resources Agency issued card as proof of successful completion of a nationally approved boater education exam administered by the Tennessee Wildlife Resources Agency.
Non-resident boat operators in the state of Tennessee who fall within the age requirement must show proof of successful passage of the National Association of Boating Law Administrators approved boater education course.
Safe boating is no accident. Take a safe boating course.
Eternal Trail for those who've got it bad. Brought to you by SRM Smyrna Readiness. Serving you with professionalism and integrity.
Folks, here's the tournament trail results from Mike's Thursday night fish-off held on Percy Priest on September 13th, 2012. In first place with 8.20 pounds, the team of Ray Thomas and Tommy Todd. In second place with 6.63 pounds, the team of Ed Jamison and Andy Jones. In third place with 6.59 pounds, the team of Joe Heron and Terry Sanders. And the big fish was a largemouth caught by Ray and Tommy, and it weighed 3.71 pounds. Congratulations to all those who participated, and thanks to Smyrna Ready Mix for sponsoring the tournament trail. And now back to Fish and Affliction.
Now you see why I like Kentucky Lake so much.
We were just talking about how the quality of the fishing, the health of the fish, and the beauty.
Just the overall numbers, it's just phenomenal. The numbers of the fish in this lake, it's like a bazillion fish in here. I can't even tell you how many fish are in here. The other day I came out here, and I caught 50 over 4 pounds and 11 pounders. 50 over 4. Can you imagine, where can you go in the country and do that? You know, Texas? I don't know. But I'm glad I'm in Tennessee doing it here.
Thank I'm with you, brother. And you know, there is a bazillion fish, and the big dog keeps catching those 1.5, 2 pounders.
I'll see if I can upgrade right here.
Good solid fish right there.
Yeah, there we go. Now we're talking another 4 pounder. Close to it, 3.5.
And I got
one. Just fish after fish after fish.
That's beautiful, isn't that?
Ooh, this good fish awesome. Right here. This is a good fish right here. Here it comes.
Oh, wow. Oh, wow.
Maybe you pull the guy off the other spot because he's watching this kitchen. What do you think? Come on, big boy. Not ready yet.
I think that's a box of big dog.
You know what? He got it, didn't he?
Boy, he did.
Come on, big boy. Open that mouth.
God. Is that cool or what?
That's a good solid fish right there.
Pushing 5?
He's a good solid 4 pounder anyway.
In the small side and the small box?
Yeah. He's a chump. Chump. And they're fun to catch, ain't they?
I wouldn't know, but though. Tell me how fun it is.
Good dang fun, ain't it, Sam?
I love it. This might be a rock fish.
I hope he's an 11 pounder.
He's gotta be a rock fish.
What is it, Sam?
It can't be a bass. Oh, it's a nice bass.
Oh my gosh.
Look at that sucker.
Sam, yeah. Can it be a bass?
4 pounder on the Shadalicious. On the Shadalicious.
Now we're going to box a few then, man.
Have we got our limit in there yet?
No, we only got 3.
Back of the boat, trying to help out, we go.
You're doing a good job. That's a good solid fish.
It's
on a 2.5, isn't it?
This is a 2.5 fish. Well, I tell you what, those must-have hooks.
I'm gonna tell you what. Strike King has the line of crankbaits out now, don't they?
Man, I'll tell you.
I just feel fortunate to be
as Salmon
with the best crankbait company in the world.
I know it.
And we weren't always able to say that. They were a great spinnerbait company and a great buzzbait company. But now they even got a heck of a topwater, don't they, Sam?
They've got everything. There's nothing they don't have. I mean, now they've got the walking dog, the sexy dog, which is a walking bait. They've got the Shadowlicious.
The KBD frog now.
Tennessee rig, which is fantastic. They've got the sexy squadron.
They got, and that's what you get.
Okay, that's a nice close up. Okay.
Well, folks, I want to slow it down for just a second to share something with you. You know, when you fish with the big dog and Slammin' Sam Lashlee, it's hard to get in on the fishing action because these guys are fishing machines. And if you're going to catch one, well, then you better make your cast in between the guys catching their fish. And I almost timed it just right. And I say almost because take a look down there in the water. As I'm bringing my fish in, the big dog had already caught one on his KVD 1.5, but he was nice enough to pick the camera up and film me for just a moment before he put the camera down and poached on Slammin' Sam Lashlee's fish.
Sam had three of them hit, and just then I throwed the rod in behind him and he just annihilated my crankbait. That's what we call poaching. Oh, look right beside the boat. Throw, Dan, throw. I got this one. Throw right there, Dan.
Well, I have my mouth there.
Dan, that's a 5-pounder.
I know, big dog, I know.
Well, folks, the Bassassination on Kentucky Lake has got everybody in the boat excited, and in a moment we'll be back with some more fishing action. But right now, let's head upstairs to the kitchen to see what Miss Vicki Porter's got cooking this week.
In the Skillet with Chef Vicki Porter is brought to you by Kleepy.com, turning your precious memories into video treasures.
Welcome to In the Skillet. I'm Vicki Porter. Today I have a delicious chicken recipe that uses a flavorful sauce. It is for sweet and spicy chicken. And now for the ingredients. You will need brown sugar, honey, soy sauce, chopped ginger, minced garlic, hot sauce, chicken tenderloins, olive oil, flour, and salt and pepper. First, we're gonna make our sauce. We're gonna mix together our ginger, our brown sugar, now our minced garlic, a little bit of hot sauce, a little bit of soy sauce, and now our honey. Get this all mixed together and this will be the sauce for our chicken. Now season your chicken with a little bit of salt and pepper. Next, coat your chicken with flour on both sides. After heating your olive oil in a skillet, add your chicken and cook it for a few minutes until it's browned on both sides. When your chicken is cooked, now add your sauce and let this simmer for about 10 to 15 minutes. After this is finished simmering, you can sit down and enjoy this sweet and spicy chicken. You can find this recipe at intheskillet.com and be sure and click on the YouTube icon to see this recipe as well as all my other In the Skillets. And be sure and send your recipe to me at vicki@intheskillet.com and you might see your recipe right here in the skillet on Fishin' Affliction TV. I'm Vicki Porter. Tune in next week to see what's cooking in the skillet.
I am Strike King.
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 Hey, I know I'm always throwing a lot of information your way, and if you want to check up with what's going on, because it may be hard to remember here sometimes, go to one of two Facebooks. Either my Facebook, which is Doug Markham Outdoors, that's M-A-R-K-H-A-M, Doug Markham Outdoors. You can go on there and I talk a whole lot, get a lot of interaction from folks that come in there, talk about hunting and fishing, or you can go to Tennessee Wildlife Resources Agency Region 2. Tennessee Wildlife Resources Agency Region 2, and you can talk on that Facebook. I do both of them. I do my personal, and then I do the one for TWA in Region 2. and we always are telling you information about the season dates, bag limits, things that are going on. But Facebook is a great way for you to communicate. And if you haven't done it yet, if you're afraid of it, get unafraid. It's very easy to do. If you can turn on a computer, you can go do Facebook. It takes you about a minute to get signed up, registered, and ready to go on everybody's sites. So they're a great way to share information, and I'm on those Facebook pages all the time. So we'll see you there, and we'll see you back here next week on Fishin' Affliction.
On today's Fishin' Affliction product spotlight, it's about the hooks that stay sharper longer, and that's these must-add hooks. From wide gap hooks to dress trebles to drop shot hooks, all kinds of hooks for every type of fishing. Must-add has the sharpest hooks on the planet, and folks, they have a hook for every kind of fishing you want to do. Head on over to must-add.no and check out the great variety of hooks from Must-add Hooks, and put one on the end of your line, and they'll stay sharper longer, and you'll catch more fish. And now back to Fishin' Affliction.
Welcome back to Fishin' Affliction, and this segment of the show is brought to you by U.S. Reel, when performance means everything. Aris Rods, don't follow, lead. Cigar Line, always the best. Must-add Ultra Point Hooks, stays sharper longer. Onyx Life Jackets, keeping you there. Fraybill, trusted gear since 1938. Blakemore's Reel Magic, the name says it all. Deca Gel Batteries, Stay in Charge Battery Charging Systems, Rugged Electronic Mounts provided by Ram Mounts, Lawrence Electronics by BBGMarine.com, and Tournament Wear. Look great, feel great, do great.
Oh, look right beside the boat. Throw, Dan, throw.
I got this one.
Throw right there, Dan.
Well, I have my mouth there.
Dan, that's a 5-pounder.
I know the dog, I know.
Got my rod. I got
not only poaching, Sam, but using your gear.
I told exactly dog and fish come up over. I thought over with that topwater, they killed it. This is going to be one phenomenal topwater right here.
Yes.
And he's solid, too.
Seems like you're getting a real big kick out of that, McDuck.
Well, I just wanted to check out and make sure Sam's bait was running straight.
It ran straight into the mouth of this big old fish.
Now, here he comes up.
I know.
Watch him.
Oh, my gosh. I know, but there's a...
No, I was just trying to keep him out of the boat, motor. Solid, ain't it?
Yeah.
Big old large job. Hey, Sam. Thank you for letting me throw your sexy dog one time.
That's a boxer, big dog.
Got another 5-pounder?
Man, oh, that's yeah. Getting close.
Hey, you know what?
That's 6 5-pounders.
That's a heck of a bait right there, buddy.
Whose bait is that, Big Dog?
I borrowed this from Sam.
Borrowed?
That's the last time he gets to throw it. He shoplifted from him.
Hey, Sam. Can't we just be friends?
He shoplifted.
Can't we just be friends, buddy?
He shoplifted from him.
There we go. This big chunk. Chunk.
I'm losing my bait.
Oh, where'd my bait go? That ain't nice.
Try Spitting King on. You got one?
Yeah, I got a Spitting King.
Try it.
I would love to, except I got time to rig.
You're not a monster, big guy.
That's a ski bass. You skied him right in there.
I thought he was just an absolute monster.
I think y'all have doubles on.
I think Sam might have the healthier fish.
I don't know. Good job. Another one on the sexy dog.
I think he is.
He's getting bigger as close as you come. I'm having to back out the back of the boat. All right, enough of y'all's mugs on the film. back to me.
Oh, yeah, fish. Back to you. Well, what you got, big dog?
Sam's getting some hits on the top water, so I went to a little bit different.
Oh, look at there.
But look at what I caught him on.
That is the wake shad, isn't it?
Yeah.
Kentucky?
Nope. He might have swam down here from Kentucky. See how this wake shad does. Wake shad kind of stays right on top of the water, kind of.
It makes a wake.
Hey.
Like a shad.
Well, I don't know many shad that make a wake like that, unless they're running for their life. Running for their life.
Another wake shad to fish, big dog?
Yeah. And Sam was good enough to get him to hit the sexy dog, and he blowed it 3 feet in the air, and then I was kind enough to throw right in behind him and catch his fish for him. Which, we are good friends like that. I don't mind catching his fish for him. And he don't mind catching mine. I mean, you know, that was a good one. Anyone that hits is a good one.
Oh, he was putting that shell too.
I think the school moved over there. I had another one hit the wakey shad. Man, you gotta put this thing on. You gotta put this other wakey shad on and throw it. I mean, it is fun.
Well, Sam, what do you think of the sexy dog?
The best topwater bait I've ever used, and that's the truth.
Can I throw it?
Nope.
I only got to throw it once. That ain't very nice.
You got a 4.5-pounder on it, too.
I think it was a 5-pounder, but who's counting?
All right, 5-pounder.
Oh, you said it. I can't believe you actually said it.
Here's one.
Well, there he went. There he went. Can't catch them all, man. Can't catch them all. You know, it's tough, but can't catch them all.
Check mine out.
Oh my gosh, Sam. Big dog, you're just, whatever you got over there is gonna be second place. Look at
I don't think he's second place.
Ooh.
You know, people, one of the questions they used to ask me about me and Sam's fishing days is, how fast can we catch a limit?
Well, folks, the guys are catching fish after fish as the Bassassination continues on Kentucky Lake. And next week, part 3 of the Bassassination 2012. So be sure to tune in next week and you'll see.
There's one. And what's this?
Rotten joker.
You guys.
This week's Team Fish and Affliction featured Facebook friend is
Liddell Wade.
And thanks for being our Facebook friend. For your chance to join in the fun and become an official Team Fish and Affliction featured Facebook friend, simply like us on Facebook. And be sure to write a comment on our wall. As always, a big thank you to all of our national and local sponsors for providing us with the most advanced technology and highest quality products and services. Be sure to visit each of our partners online through the sponsor links page on our official website at fishandaffliction.com. And this is your old pal Matthew Gillen, the voice of Fish and Affliction TV, hoping that you'll tune in next week, because there's no doubt that Dan and the Big Dog got it bad. They've got Fishin' Affliction for those who got it bad.
Ooh! Boy, look at this way. 27.09.